Homelessness is a major issue in the city of Salem. We determined that there was one group in town getting no assistance, and that was the what we term the hardest to house. They have addiction, mental health, or other issues that have really created a barrier to getting them housing. And then the other question was, what do we have available for housing? And we realized we have landlords, and we agreed that this program would target landlords. The city would provide the front end payment for it. And what we would have is a housing first program preparing people to come off the street and stay off the street. I believe very strongly that you deal with people one person at a time, because the issues are always different, and you do it one day at a time with them, helping them through a threshold that for many is very difficult, which is moving into housing even after living on the street that many years. And this program has resulted in the largest housing first program in the state. We have created a system of wraparound services that deal with health, addiction, mental health issues, and we're having tremendous success. In fact, one of the most moving things I've done in some time was a couple months ago, the graduation of our first class of folks who've gone through this that are moving now from this housing into low-income housing using vouchers. And I had so many people come up and say, this has just changed my life, which is exactly what we wanted to do.
It was going from having nothing except what was in my pockets to now I have a bed, now I have some dishware, a dish drying rack. I don't think I've ever even owned one of those before I was homeless. I had gotten, you know, some more than basic needs, I'd almost say, that really, really made the transition for me going from homeless to, and having nothing to being housed and having things that just make me feel comfortable and secure with a foundation that I can build on. Mm-hmm. It's been 11 months so far with the program, but I am actually graduated from it and moved on to, really? Yes, being so fully self-sufficient. You're not gonna be sure what or how to feel. And it just takes time. That's what they've given you here, is this time to really figure out who you are as an individual, what is gonna take for your recovery to be successful as an individual, what your strengths are gonna be, what your hope is gonna look like. They hold hope for you if you can't hold hope for yourself. I went to volunteering with Project Able at the front desk reception, basically getting to know everybody. And eventually what they did was they offered me a full-time staff position as a trauma and wellness program coordinator. And then that developed into a volunteer coordinator. So any and every volunteer that comes through Project Able, they end up meeting with me and actually going through an orientation. And now it's time to build the roof to this magnificent home that I have. And that looks like education, that looks like growing my family, and mainly is it providing back to what has been provided back to, given to me.
And I was so pleased with this, and have been, and I'm so committed to it. And the city council is as well. This entered our strategic plan. It has ongoing funding. We are committed to it on the long term. I am so proud of people who can take that challenge and move forward in their lives. And I'm really proud of the city for leading this effort. I think it's one of the things that I'm surprised we were able to do as well, because we're not a social service agency. So all my hat's off to the Housing Authority, to Arches and the Mid-Willamette Valley Community Action Agency, but particularly to the landlords who will accept this population, and then the folks who are trapped in this situation, who are willing to take this giant step in their lives back out and back into the society that we all live in, that gives them a sense of pride and hope, I think, is so much of it.